All right, 7:25. Today we pause and we reflect on the significance of the horrific events of September 11, 2001. But what about our Keiki? Many young children may hear about 9/11, no matter how much we try to shield them. There are also many parents who want to tell their children what happened on 9/11, but they just don't know where to start. Mm-hmm. Dr. Suzanne Gelb joins us now with your thoughts on that, because we come up on this date every year.
Yes.
And a new set of preschoolers or even youngsters say, what happened that day? What do we do? How do we deal with that?
It can be quite a dilemma. Well, first of all, you want to ask the preschoolers, and actually this applies to all kids, you want to find out what do they know. So you ask them, what have you heard? Do you know anything at all about 9/11? You may be surprised how much, as we were talking earlier, young kids really know. A four-year-old, for example, may have picked up little bits and then try to make sense out of it. So parents for this age group, you want to clear up any misconceptions. You want your answers to be brief and simple and reassure them that they are safe.
I like that, especially this last point, because when you see those images, and boy, they haunt us still as adults.
Yes.
You can feel this sense of, are we safe, mom and dad?
Yes.
Yeah, so emphasize that, the safety.
Absolutely.
Now, what else do we need to know about this particular day, especially when it comes to our elementary school children?
Well, generally speaking, they've probably picked up a thing or two about 9/11 from TV, from their teachers, or from school. Again, you and their peers, you want to find out what do you know, and you want to clear up any misconceptions, again, any misinformation. Make sure your explanations are age-appropriate. For this group, don't give too much detail, just enough. And you can engage them in a dialogue. I mean, ask them, of course, age-appropriate, how do you feel about this tragedy? And again, reassure them that the authorities are doing everything possible to keep them safe.
Now, our middle school age children, they see things in a different lens. What's the message there?
Well, they typically, generally speaking, have formed a perception of 9/11. So there, get them talking. Listen to what they have to share before you input. And like you were saying earlier, for kids of all ages, limit the sensational images that they see of the Twin Towers, you know, falling and things like that. There's enough appropriate images for them to see that aren't that graphic. Parents, too, though, need to model appropriate behavior.
Right.
So they don't want to stay glued to the coverage during this anniversary. It's not good for them or the kids.
Because what we do, how we react, how we reflect, often mimicked by our children.
Absolutely, yes.
Okay, I know you have much about this website on your website as well.
Yes, drsuzannegelb.com. Take a look there, and there's lots of supportive information for parents on how to deal with this and just parenting in general.
Thank you, Dr.
Thank you.
It's a very important topic, again, because we will never forget the events of 9/11, 2001.
We won't.
All right, thank you, Doctor.